Hey everyone, this is Jose with EXP, and I want to talk to you today about buying a home and how things are changing. One of the biggest changes is how much money buyers are having to bring to the table in order to purchase a home. Now, in the past, when buyers went house hunting, they found a house, they liked it, they put an offer was accepted. They would go through the appraisal process, they would go through inspection process. And then they would come to closing, and typically they would bring the cash, which was a combination of the down payment, closing costs, which are required, and then also prepaid expenses, which are typically taxes and insurance. Well, these days, because of changes in rules and regulations, in addition to the down payment, closing costs and prepaid expenses, buyers are now having to bring a buyer's commission expense to the table. So this was an expense that buyers never saw directly before. It was implied that the sellers would pay all the commission. Now, sellers don't have to pay commission for the buyer's agent. Now, this is good and bad. The good is your buyer's agent now works for you exclusively. In the past, if you did not have a written agreement with a buyer's agent, the seller was paying your buyer's agent. So guess where their loyalty may reside with the person that's paying them. Now, the good news is you as a buyer are going to be paying the commission, which means you have a agent that is on your side. He is loyal to you and he will negotiate vigorously on your behalf. The downside is there's an additional expense that you didn't pay before that now you're having to pay. And that may be a little bit of sticker shock for some people, particularly first-time home buyers who may have limited cash. So, what do? Make sure you're working with a buyer's agent that is going to negotiate vigorously on your behalf, negotiate the best price, the best terms, and in some cases, negotiate a seller's credit that will help cover some of their commission. Now, keep this in mind. They're negotiating on the buyer's behalf to get a seller's credit. That's different than in the past, where the seller was paying the seller agent's commission and paying the buyer's agent commission, which indirectly meant that the buyer's agent was working for the seller as well as the seller's agent was working for the seller. So this brings equity. There's not necessarily a bad thing about it. You just have to have your eyes open and understand that the rules have changed and the way buying a home is changing. And you want to make sure you're working with a realtor that understands these changes and is going to work aggressively to get you the best price, best terms. And if there's seller credits involved, get you the most amount of seller credits possible to then make it easier for you to buy a home. Feel free to give me a call or drop a note in the comments below, and let's get started.